And now we will learn how to track profit and loss by tenant. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The Write Checks window is the place to record expenses as you pay them. It's very simple to put in check information. What will happen in the trial balance when we pay an expense? Well, whatever expense we're paying is going to go up at the moment that we pay it. And of course, if we pay from the bank account, cash in bank goes down. So that will be the effect that you will see in the trial balance when we record our first check. However, the profit and loss by tenant will actually change if you attribute that expense to a specific tenant. So you may remember that we already set up a report to show us the profit and loss by tenant. And when we click here to open it up, you can see that it remembers we wanted all dates. And if you scroll from left to right, you can see the income and expense for each tenant. Notice this line here where the mouse is pointing to, where the line gets thicker. That means when you scroll, the row headings will stay in the same place. You just scroll to the right to see the different tenants and their numbers as they relate to the headings on the left. So you can see the rental income earned for Alan is $4,000, the amount earned, that is. The amount earned from Betty is only $2,000. We actually earned more, but we haven't recorded those invoices. For Candy, it was $2,000. We can scroll forward. Okay. For Dave Deeney, it was $2,000. And so forth. That's because we only recorded, you know, a couple of months. But notice income from late fees. There's $50 that we earned from Betty as income from late fees. And there's $100 that we earned from Dave Deeney as income from late fees. So the total income from Dave is $2,100. Now you'll notice it's only listing the income items up here because so far in this course, we've only had income items. But once we start recording expenses that are specific to a tenant, you'll see those expenses listed here, and then you'll know your true profit and loss by tenant. So for example, let's imagine on March 15th, we paid check number one for $200 to Staples for supplies that specifically relate to apartment 1A where Alan resides. Now we're not billing Alan. Alan's balance does not change because we are not making Alan responsible for this money in this particular example. But the profit and loss by tenant will change, so we can see that this is an expense that still relates to him. And of course, the trial balance changes for every transaction that we do. So how do we record this March 15th check to Staples for supplies? Well, we have to click expenses. And actually, we don't click, and then we could click expenses here. But it would actually be better for you to enter these things if you're physically writing a check, to click the plus sign and to notice if the column all the way to the left is for customers, then the second column is for vendors. And then you can click check. Now, the computer assumes the first check is check number one. You can change this to whatever the physical check number is on the check that you're actually mailing out. You're just recording it here in QuickBooks. Now, it's coming from this bank account, and we said we are paying Staples. And the day that we're paying Staples, I believe it said March 15th. So we'll make sure that we're in March 15th of 2019. And the category is the expense. So click directly under the word category to bring the pull-down arrow. Then click the pull-down arrow and scroll down to supplies expense. In our case, supplies are written off as expenses as soon as they're purchased. And I believe the amount was $200. Click here for $200. There we go. Now you will not check the billable box. The billable box you will only check if you are making the customer responsible. You're not making the tenant responsible, but you still want to know which tenant this applies to. So where it says customer, click the pull down arrow and choose A1, specifically Alan Arby. So you're paying $200 for supplies for the apartment of Alan Arby, and that's the first expense that we're recording in QuickBooks, and this is the physical check number that you're signing and sending in the mail to Staples. Click Save and Close, and now let's go back to Reports, and let's go to Profit and Loss by Tenant, and you can see for Alan, even though you earned $4,000 of income from rental income, Alan's apartment cost you $200 in supplies, so you really only have $3,800 in profit from that specific apartment. You should also notice that if you click Reports, Trial Balance All, you can see that supplies expense shows up as a general expense for the company as well. And no matter which apartment you pay an expense for, it will also show up in total for everyone here on the trial balance. Now, as usual, we'll solidify this with a second example. Let's imagine on March 16th, we pay check number 2 for $300 to Rex Repair for apartment 4D where Dave Deeney resides. Now, we're not billing Dave. We're not making him responsible for the money, and we're not yet adding it to his balance. All we're doing, see, his balance won't change, even though we still want to know which apartment this repair was associated with. So it'll affect the profit and loss by tenant, and it will affect the trial balance. So let's take a look. We again go to the plus sign here, go to the second column, and the second choice down is check. Now, QuickBooks assumes it's check number 2, and again, you could put whatever number you want, and then the very next time you open the window, it'll put the next consecutive number. In this case, the payee is Rex Repair, and of course, the date is March 16th that we wrote him the check, and the category, click under category to bring the arrow, click the pull down arrow to choose the expense. In this case, it's repair expense. The amount is $300. Push the tab key on your keyboard to save the field without losing the whole window. Now make sure you remove the check mark. Make sure that there's no check mark where it says billable. And we're going to attribute this to Dave Deeney, even though we're not billing him and increasing his balance yet. So let's just click Save and Close. And if you look at the trial balance, you can see repair expense shows up for the first time as $300. And these two checks just decrease the cash in bank. Look, I double-click the balance of cash in bank. And you can see what we received from the tenants were positive. But you can see these last two checks for expenses were negative. And of course, we can click expense. And then we can click reports. And then we can go to the profit and loss by tenant, and we can see that if you go across to Dave Deeney, even though we earned $2,100, we earned $2,100 from Dave Deeney, we still lost $300 for repairs for his apartment. So far the real profit and loss from that apartment is $1,800. And in closing, let's just double check that the tenant's balances have not changed at all for these expenses. Reports, tenant balance detail. Look, Alan's balance, nothing was recorded against Alan's balance for this. And the same thing for Dave Deeney. I have to open Dave Deeney. Nothing for Dave Deeney was recorded, just the late fee, but we did not record the repair against Dave Deeney's balance. That we will learn in the following video.